insisted I bring it for good luck.
Yay!
Because she knows I don't perform, so. Alas, my lord husband has ripped his hose open again. So I gather up my basket of needles and thread, I light a fresh candle, and I set to work. And this is how you accomplish that dastardly task known as threading a needle. Oh. 'Tis not nearly easy as it looks. First, find a needle that's right for the job. Nothing too big, nothing too small. You need something just right. Secondly, hold the sharp beastie up in the light, the wee eye for it to see. Making sure you can find it is a trick. And if you are anything like me, you'll probably be squinting to find it. Thirdly, you grab up your thread and trim it to the length that you desire. You stick out your tongue and slowly approach the thread end to the eye and try to glide it in. And this.
Of course.
Again. And again. And again. And at this point, you find yourself dampening the end of the thread with your spit, knowing it'll make it slide right in. Beautiful. You take up your needle, you take up the thread, and you miss it. And you miss again. You groan in frustration, you push up your sleeves. You're not going to let it get the best of you. There's a hole in the knee. You will not give in. You again whip the thread, giving it a little spin in your fingers. You squint and hold your breath as you slowly pull the thread closer and closer, and you miss yet again. You sigh and you curse and you steel yourself for one last go-round. You're bound, you're determined, it shall not best you. You take a deep breath, look at Squirt, its puny metal eye, and with breath held in concentration at its highest, you advance your thread. What's this? It worked? Lo and behold, the eye has been run through and the battle is won.